The Philippines' justice chief refutes concerns the government is depriving Filipinos of an avenue for justice with its decision not to rejoin the International Criminal Court. Jesus Remulla says it's indisputable that domestic courts are functioning. The main issue, he claims, is a lack of witnesses coming forward. Remulla also doubles down on the government's stance that the ICC no longer has jurisdiction over the Philippines.
When you withdraw from the ICC and you cease to become a member, then what activities can they hold in your country that will be sanctioned by your country as part of a treaty participant? Since you are no longer a treaty participant, you are no longer part of the ICC. So it's just logical that if you're not part of the ICC, the activities of the ICC will cease as far as your country is concerned. If they want to conduct an activity in this country, it has to be sanctioned by the Philippine government. Once you withdraw from the treaty, then everything else that goes with it ceases.
The Philippines withdrew from the ICC in 2019 when the Rome Statute began a preliminary probe into the Duterte administration's drug war. President Marcos on Monday declared the Philippines has no intention of going back to the ICC. The group, Philippine Coalition for the International Criminal Court, accused Marcos of depriving Filipinos of a court of last resort. President Marcos urges local governments to be more open to public-private partnerships, or the PPP. In a meeting with local chief executives Tuesday, Marcos also stressed digitalization will play a key role in PPP projects, especially for economic recovery and digital transformation in the country. The president also encouraged local leaders to become the driving force in their areas to promote economic reform.
Let's keep that truism in our minds and make it show people that that is exactly what we're going to happen. The LGUs can lead the way when it comes to changing our country from the bottom up. And that's what we're going to have to do, because what we are doing nothing less now than transforming our economy into a post-pandemic.
Private hospitals in the Philippines see a slight increase in COVID admissions. But Dr. Jose Rene Degrano, the president of the Private Hospitals Association of the Philippines, says the situation is still manageable. He adds they're now preparing their isolation rooms following the detection of the Centaurus Omicron subvariant, as well as the monkeypox virus in the country.
What we are doing right now is just the same, more or less, what we are doing during the COVID pandemic. You know? We are preparing for our isolation areas, because what is important here is awareness, our detection, and of course, isolation of these suspect cases.
The Philippines implements another border screening measure as a precaution against monkeypox. Incoming passengers of international flights will now be asked to roll up their sleeves as they enter the country's main gateway. This is on top of thermal scanners which monitor body temperature.
Dinidisrobe natin yung mga jackets na hanggat maaari makita natin yung mga signs and symptoms na kailangan nating makita. We do the primary screening using the thermal scanner, and then if we see the quarantine medical officer sees that this person needs to be evaluated further, we do our secondary screening.
The Bureau of Quarantine admits the screening test for incoming passengers is not foolproof, but it can minimize the risk of more cases of monkeypox entering the country.
Hindi naman po lahat nagpe-present with fever. And then after the fever, yung rashes tsaka lang po yan magde-develop. So that's one of the challenges. Kaya hindi po natin masasabi na yung pasaherong dadaan ay makakatch natin on time.
Ang importante sa border natin na meron tayong monitoring kung sino man yung darating at kung mag-develop ng symptoms within the next three weeks upon arrival, dapat meron tayong way of monitoring those individuals.